Now we'll see the factor theorem. If P of X is a polynomial, we don't know that polynomial. Let us take some example to understand what is a polynomial. This is my P of X is a polynomial. I would like to take something X square plus 2X plus 1. This is a polynomial. The degree is 2. Is greater than 1, right? The degree is greater than 1. And A be a real number. A be a some real number. I would like to take some 1 here. I would like to take here 1. A be any real number here, but I take in 1 is a real number for this polynomial. Then here comes x minus 1. Is a factor of P of X. X minus 1 is a factor of my P of X. Then P of 1 must be 0. Let us check it out. Some P of 1 I take it, 1 square plus 2 into 1 plus 1. 1 plus 2 plus 1. Why? 1 square is nothing but 1. 2 1 are 2. This is equals to
4.
4. So P of 1 is not equals to 0. Isn't it? Suppose again P of X is a polynomial of degree is greater than 1. This is my degree is greater than 1. And here I would like to A be a any real number, but here I would like to take minus 1 again. My real number is how much?
Minus
1. Then here comes how much? Minus 1. Minus or minus?
Plus
1. Okay? Let us check it out with the help of P of minus 1 is equals to, here comes minus 1 whole square. In place of X, I am taking minus 1. Plus 2 into minus 1 plus 1. Minus 1 whole square is nothing but how much?
Plus 1.
Why? Because minus 1 into minus 1. Can I write it down here? Minus 1 into minus. Minus into minus plus. Plus 1, 1, 0, 1. Plus into minus minus. 2, 1, 0, 2 plus 1. 1 plus 1 how much?
2.
2 minus 2 equals to 0. So P of minus 1 is equals to 0. So P of minus 1 is equal to 0, therefore x plus 1, because minus of minus, x plus 1 is a factor of P of X. Is it clear or not? This is the meaning of the definition. Suppose if you take some other example. Some other example. I would like to take now third degree polynomial. P of X is equals to some X square minus X cube minus 3X square plus 3X plus 1. Again, I would like to take here some small real number 1. Real number 1. Is given A is a real number. I take in 1. Therefore, X minus 1 is to be factor of P of X. My P of X, this one. This third degree polynomial. Then P of 1 must be equals to how much?
0.
And trial and error I am taking. If X is equals to 1, I take it. Minus, 1 cube minus 3 into 1 square plus 3 into 1 plus 1. In place of X, I am taking how much?
1.
By taking 1 here, how much? 1. 1 square is nothing but how much?
1.
1 3 is 0.
3.
3 1 0.
3.
Plus 1. Plus 3 minus 3?
Cancels.
Plus 1 minus 1?
Cancels.
Therefore, x minus 1 is a factor of
0.
X minus 1 is a factor of my P of X. Very simple. If P of X be a polynomial of degrees greater than 1, a real number, see here. A is a real number. Then X minus A is a real number. Then X minus A is a factor of some P of X. Then P of A must be equals to 0. This is the factor theorem. So let us see, by long division method, is it right up? Is it right up? Okay? This is my cubic polynomial. I'm taking how much number? So x minus 1 is taken. X minus 1 I take. Wait. So x cube divided with x. X cube divided with
x.
How much will come?
X square.
Write it down, x square. X square multiplied with
x minus 1.
This is equals to
x cube minus x square.
So x cube minus x square. By subtracting, these two get cancelled. And this becomes plus and minus what to do?
Cancel.
Less and minus what to do? Subtract. 3x square minus x square?
Minus.
2x square minus because this is bigger. Plus 3x. Again, 2x square minus 2x square divided with x gives minus 2x. Here minus 2x. Minus 2x is multiplied with x minus 1. How much will come?
Minus 2x square.
Minus 2x square plus 2x.
2x.
So minus 2x square plus 2x. By subtracting, these two get cancelled and this becomes minus. We get x plus 1. X divided with x 1 and 1 is multiplied by this.
X minus 1.
Oh, 1 minute, 1 minute. You have done a small mistake. Here, this into this. Yes. No. There, minus here, plus, right? How much? That is x minus 1, right? I think plus. This is minus. I done a small mistake. Here comes a minus. Right? So 1 is multiplied by that, x minus 1, use the remainder,
0.
Here I done wrong, here minus. Once again I will check it out, once see here. By factor theorem I would like to find remainder. Remainder must be how much will come?
0.
This is my polynomial, p of x is equals to how much? X cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 1, right?
Yes, sir.
Here forgot to write this. Minus 1. So P of how much you have to take?
1.
Plus 1. You take here 1, right? Here 1. So 1 cube minus 3 into 1 square plus 3 into 1 minus 1, right? 1 cube is nothing but 1. 1 square is nothing but 1 minus 3 plus 3 and minus 1. 3 1 ja 3. Less 3 minus 3, minus 1. Less 1 minus 1. See, by long division method we got 0. It divides completely this one or not? Therefore this is factor of this one or not? Here also given the same statement. See here. If P of x is a polynomial of degree n is greater than 1 and A be any real number, A be any real number, then x minus a is a factor of p of x, then p of a equals to
0.
So, it converts, you can say that if x minus a is a factor of p of x, then p of a equals to 0. Very simple, x minus a is a factor of polynomial p of x, then p of a must be equals to 0. It's clear or not? This is my p of x is divided by x minus 1. That means this is the 0 of this polynomial, how much? 0 of this polynomial. X minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equals to 1. Then P of 1 is equals to 0, see here, by substituting 1 here we get 0. That's the reason x minus 1 is the factor of this one. By this proof, you can write generally, if P of x be any polynomial, if degree n is greater than 1, some real number a is a real number, then x minus a is a real number, then x minus a is a what? Linear polynomial. Is a factor of p of x if p of a equals to 0.